Hello dear students, today we are going to do an experiential learning on polygons and how do we find the number of diagonals in it. I hope you all are ready to participate in this learning journey. So first of all, I would like to know from all of you, what do you mean by a polygon? What is a polygon? Yes, a polygon is a closed figure made up of only line segments. So interestingly, we see that there are two important facts. Number one, it's a closed shape. And number two, it is made up of only line segments. So I'm going to take up the line segment tool from here to just see if we have one line segment, can we make a closed shape? No, we cannot. You're right. Okay, so let us see if we have two line segments. Can we make a closed shape? Let me try once again. So what do you observe? Like, I'm trying to use the two line segments. Yes, you are right. We are not able to make a closed shape with two line segments. Okay, so let us now take three line segments. Can we make a closed shape? Okay, let us try again. Yes, we are able to make a closed shape with three line segments. And this is called a triangle. Tri means three. I did a video on what should be the lengths of the line segments so that we are able to make a triangle, and I hope you remember that we will be able to make a triangle with the given sides if sum of any two sides is greater than the third side. We did this experiential learning activity few days ago. Okay, so moving further, let us see if we have four line segments, then can we get a closed shape? And this is a simple closed curve also. We call it as a simple closed curve made up of line segments. Yes, we are able to do so. And this four-sided polygon is called a quadrilateral. Quad means four. Okay, now we are going to learn how we can find the number of diagonals in a given polygon. So first of all, let us understand what is a diagonal. So I'm going to change the color here so that you can understand it well. So let us consider this triangle MLN. Let me move on this alphabet L so that you can see this better. Okay, so here we have the triangle LMN. Now tell me, what is a diagonal? So diagonal is basically formed by joining the vertex with another vertex on the polygon. Condition is that the other vertex should not be the consecutive one. So if we start with the vertex L, then if we join LN, N is the consecutive vertex. So it gives us side of this triangle. Similarly, if we join L with M, it gives us side of the triangle. So no other vertex is left. So that means we cannot have any diagonal in a triangle. Let us see from this vertex N. NL is side and M is also side. So there is no other vertex left to join with N. So we cannot make any diagonal. So we see that in a triangle, there is no diagonal. Now let us explore this quadrilateral. So the name of the quadrilateral is SRUT. You can have any name, no problem in it. Okay, so let us begin with S. So we see that if we join S with T, we get the side. We can join S with U to get the diagonal. And if we join S with R, we get another side of the quadrilateral. So there is one diagonal possible starting from the vertex S. Similarly, if we start from the vertex T, one diagonal we can draw, that is TR. Similarly, if we start from the vertex U, we get the diagonal US, which is same as SU. Please make this observation. SU, US. That will help you in counting the total number of diagonals. Now, from the vertex R, you see one diagonal can be drawn, which is already TR, the same diagonal TR. Now, I am going to ask you certain questions and you have to think and reply on the basis of observations. You tell me, number one, how many diagonals are there which you see here? Diagonals in a quadrilateral. You can see two diagonals. Okay, let us now see the other observations. I am considering N as number of vertices. Number of vertices in a quadrilateral is 4. I am writing here number of vertices. Now tell me number of diagonals which you can drawn from each vertex. From each vertex, you can see, you can draw one diagonal. And what is total number of diagonals? Can I say this is equal to N into N minus 3 divided by 2? Now I will tell you how I have got this. N we have taken as N is equal to 4. That is the number of vertices. And number of diagonals drawn from each vertex is 1. And I can write it as 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3. That means this is equal to N minus 3. And I told you in the beginning that please make the observation that the diagonal SU and US, they are the same. So total number of diagonals will be N, that is the number of diagonals, multiply by N minus 3, that is number of diagonals drawn from each vertex, divided by 2, because we don't want to take the repetitive diagonals. So n into n minus 3 divided by 2. So what is n? N is 4. 4 into 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. 4 into 1 divided by 2. And you get the answer as 2. Hence, it is verified. Is it not interesting? Okay. So, let us explore this further by working on a pentagon. So, now you tell me what is a pentagon. Pentagon. I hope you have heard about it. So, pentagon is five-sided polygon. So, I am trying to make now a closed figure made up of five line segments. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. Okay. So, let us now try to draw the diagonals. I'm starting from the vertex B1. First, you tell me how many vertices are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, n is 5. So, from each vertex, how many diagonals you can draw? 5 minus 3, that is 2. Let us first draw that. 1, 2. Let us now begin from A1. 1, 2. Let us now begin from Z. 1 is already drawn, that is ZB1. B1Z is same as ZB1. So, which will be the next one? That is ZV. Okay. From W, already 2 are drawn. And from V also, already 2 are drawn. So, let us now write down this. So, what is N here? What is N here? N is number of vertices. Number of vertices. Number of vertices is, we have taken as, this is equal to n is equal to 5. So, number of diagonals drawn from each vertex, that will be equal to n minus 3, which is 5 minus 3, which is 2. Now, after this, total number of diagonals. Total number of diagonals is, now you tell me the formula, n into n minus 3. Y divided by 2, because we are not going to count the repeated ones. So, n into n minus 3 divided by 2, that is 5 into 5 minus 3, that is 2 divided by 2. And this gives us 5. And you can see that we have drawn 5 diagonals. Is it not interesting? You tell me. So, this is, learning of mathematics is a journey. And each one of you has to travel your own journey. The basic thing is, observation plays a key role. So, observe the minute facts and try to understand. And that will really, really help you in developing the concepts. Right? So, practice this and see that you can also understand the formulas and derive the formulas by drawing the figures and making suitable observations and making certain reflections on it. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.